before again the network, before the network goes away again, let's quickly do the question answer. One, differentiate between summer solstice and winter solstice. Now, E1 will be answered by drawing a line in between, and then you will write the two columns, winter solstice and summer solstice, and then you divide the column. The first point for summer solstice, the summer solstice occurs when the sun reaches its highest point in the northern hemisphere. Now, first point for winter solstice is when sun reaches its lowest point in the northern hemisphere. Second, the regions receive direct sunlight on the earth. Winter solstice, second point, the region does not receive direct sunlight on the earth. Number three, days are longer and nights are shorter. Number three, for winter solstice, nights are longer and days are shorter. Number four, the summer solstice occurs every year on 21st June. Winter solstice falls on 22nd December. Now coming to the E2 answer. Will somebody read out the question for me? E2. Somebody please quickly read out.
Ma'am, long answer, E2. Why does the southern hemisphere experience winter and summer solstice in different times than that of the northern hemisphere?
Very good. Now the answer for this is E2. Regardless of the time of the year, the northern and southern hemispheres always experience opposite seasons. This is because during summer or winter, one part of the planet is more directly exposed to the rays of the sun than the other. And this position changes as the earth revolves in its orbit. E3, please read out E3 question.
How does the phenomenon of seasons occur?
Okay, thank you, child. Now, E3, you will be writing in 4 points. Can you see the double tick everywhere in red color? With every double tick is a new point. Now, first point is, it is seen that when the sun shines vertically overhead at the Tropic of Cancer on 21st June, the northern hemisphere enjoys the summer season and the southern hemisphere enjoys the winter season. Number two, the second point you write from a new line. As the sun travels southward, it is vertically overhead at the equator on 23rd September. Thus, the northern hemisphere enjoys the autumn season and the southern hemisphere enjoys the spring season. Third point, as the sun reaches its maximum southern limit on 22nd December, its position is vertically overhead at the Tropic of Capricorn. Thus, the southern hemisphere enjoys the summer season, while the northern hemisphere enjoys the winter season. Fourth point, next, the sun moves northward, and on 21st March, its position is vertically overhead at the equator. Thus, the northern hemisphere enjoys the spring season, and the southern hemisphere enjoys the autumn season. That's it, E3. Now, coming to E4A, will somebody read out?
Differentiate between A, rotation and revolution, B, summer and winter solstice.
Okay, so for E4A, rotation and revolution, these are the five differentiated points which you'll write. Rotation, the movement of the earth on its axis is called rotation. Revolution, the movement of the earth around the sun is called revolution. Now, second differentiation, the Earth takes 24 hours to complete one rotation. B point, the Earth takes about 365 days, 5 hours, 48 minutes, and 56 seconds to complete one revolution. C, rotation is also known as the daily motion of the Earth. Revolution is also known as the annual motion of the earth. Next point, rotation gives the concept of day, whereas revolution gives the concept of year. Last differentiation, it causes day and nights. Next year, on the revolution, it causes seasons. Now, E4A, till here you will do, and E4B is the differentiation between summer solstice and winter solstice. So this you have done here only. So you need not worry. You can, on E4A, you can write same as E1 and you need not copy the question again. That's it. This is what I was wanting to tell you. Now, next class, when we meet, we will be beginning with the geography, civics, last chapter, and we will gradually finish our course within that. We have entirely 10-15 days for complete revision. Are we clear with this? Open your mics.